Now it's time to start optimizing your site. So in this video, we'll look at how the conversion rate optimization process works with Webflow Optimize in 6 parts. First, we'll create an optimization. We'll build and preview our variations. We'll allocate how much traffic goes to each variation. We'll launch our variations. We'll review the results of our optimizations. And finally, we'll make another optimization with personalization. Before we get started, we first need to generate ideas that we want to test and optimize on our site. This will come pretty naturally as you test and learn from your audience, but you can start with prominent things like your hero image, site copy, or offers. But for us, we're going to try different calls to action. Now that we know our idea, let's create an optimization. Here we are in Webflow. If you don't have Optimize on your site, you'll want to go into Insights and add Optimize to your site. But once you do, over here at the top, let's go up to Optimizations and we'll create a new test to compare different versions of our main call to action, our CTA. Let's give our optimization a name, something to describe what we're testing here. And we have 2 options, traditional and AI optimized. We'll get into the differences here later, but for now, we'll start with a traditional test. Okay, now that we've created our optimization, we need to build some variations. Up here on the context bar, you can see which variation we're working on. You'll see your base variation, which has the original CTA on the site, and then our first variation is created for us. But let's rename it to something meaningful. And then, right on the canvas, we can select the element we want to create different variations of. We can click in and type in our new call to action. That's one variation. Let's make a second one. Back to the context bar, add a variation, name it, and add in the CTA copy for this one. And just to make sure we have everything set up right, we can switch between the variations to preview each of them, and then we can exit out from the context bar to go back to the base variation. Now that we've built the variations, let's manage how much traffic goes to each variation. In the context bar, we'll go to Settings and Goals. Here you can choose a traffic allocation, either an even distribution between all variations or a manual split of your choice totaling 100%. So we'll go with 40%, 40%, and 20%, and save. Next part, this one's really quick. In order to publish our optimizations, we first need to make sure data tracking on our site is enabled. We can do that in the Insights settings. Once we've done that, we publish our site, which launches our variations. Now our visitors will see our different CTA buttons based on the allocation we set. So, what we did was the traditional test option. So now's a good time to revisit the difference between a traditional and AI-optimized test. Had we chosen AI-optimized, we wouldn't have to split traffic. Optimize would adjust visitor traffic in real time, learning from visitor behavior and automatically showing the variations most likely to convert. This is great for when you want to test multiple variations and combinations of variations rapidly. It also provides a personalized experience for each visitor. Now that our optimization is out there, let's review the results. As visitors start interacting with your page and variations, within the All Optimizations menu, you can see a report of real-time results. We'll see an overview with success rates for each variation, along with audience insights. Now, with a traditional test, this will go on until a statistically significant winning variation is identified, the one with the highest conversion rate. And that's where the test ends. But if we choose an AI-optimized test, instead of selecting a single winner, Optimize dynamically directs visitors to the variation that is best for them. So it learns which variations perform better with each individual and automatically presents the combination most likely to convert them. That's reviewing test results. Let's make a new optimization using personalization. Same place, but we'll add a new personalization. Let's give it a name. And with a manual personalization, you create audiences and build variations for them. But what do we mean by an audience? Audiences can represent a lot of things, from users on certain devices to those who have engaged in behaviors like viewing a specific page before. For example, let's create an audience for visitors on desktop computers. And we match these audiences that we define with a variation. Because we already created an optimization on the CTA button, let's make a longer hero tagline for our audience visiting on desktop computers, which have larger screens. And just like with testing, we set up our variations on the canvas where we design and build each variation. Now, after we've launched and we review results of a personalization, our report will show how each variation is performing with its assigned audience. And with AI Optimize, it works to match each visitor to the variation that's best for them. just like it did with our testing example. This automates showing the right content, so you don't need to create manual rules. So that's personalization. Now, the optimization process is a continuous cycle. You'll want to regularly revisit your strategy and build and test new variations to maximize your conversion rate over time. So, to recap, we created an optimization, we built and previewed our variations, we allocated traffic to our variations, and then we launched our variations. Next, we reviewed the results of our optimizations, and finally, we made another optimization with personalization. And that's how to get started optimizing your site with Webflow Optimize.